Hello and welcome to the debut episode of Badger Speaks. We are live in Studio A in the SFFL headquarters. We did bring you Badgers Beats. Now, it's Badger Speaks. I am the SFFL reporter, Badger Sampson. You will see the different owners come in each episode, but you'll always see a familiar face here. SFFL Commissioner Clay Harvey.
Nice to be here.
Probably should be shaking hands. We're in, quarantine. But we got some breaking news over the last couple of days that we'd like to discuss here. So the first breaking news, banger right here. Ryan Cole is back in the SFFL. You never would have thought it, would you?
Wow, what a day. He was in the league in 2016 and then left, and then all of a sudden he came in the G League, kicked all our asses, and now he's back.
Yep.
He wanted back in, he's in, and the Devil Dogs took him in.
Wow. And Alex, the owner of the Do-Si-Do, did say that he was first place in the other league that he did and lost in the playoffs. So hopefully Ryan can bring some of that flavor to the Devil Dogs. And that is some other breaking news. The Cheddar Dogs, 2018 founded, one of the best franchises in the SFFL, are gone. And they have changed to the Devil Dogs. My favorite team right here, the Devil Dogs. I love it. How do you feel about this one, Commish?
That's a great name. I didn't see that coming. It's going to be a good franchise, and it's going to be crazy to see two owners.
Yeah, it's going to be crazy. Both Ryan and Elijah together, those two people, you would love to see in a draft room right there because they kill it on draft day. So now we got the next part and one of the more exciting parts. The Alabama Do-Si-Do with their first front office and coaching staff. How do you feel about Nick Saban and Mike Turk leading that Do-Si-Do front?
I think it was a good creation. You know, Alex is pushing the league forward. I think we're going to see some owners do it in the future. It sets a nice tone.
And what owner do you believe will start that trend?
I think Sean's right on the edge of doing it. He's ready.
Sean's ready. You got word from him?
No word. I just feeling.
Just feeling. So, as we all know, the SFFL is currently in a lockdown for 30 days. Mm-hmm. As soon as the NBA went on lockdown, the SFFL did. How do you feel about that process, and when do you think it's going to finish?
Well, I think it was necessary at the time. Obviously, this is a big emergency or something. But, look, I said 30 days. Once we get to that mark, which is coming very soon, the lockout will be over. The NBA, the NFL, the rest of the world, you know, they can be pansies and they can be like, oh, we shouldn't be meeting. No, 30 days is up, we're back to work in the SFFL. That's what we do.
Wow. I cannot wait for the start of a new season in the SFFL. I'd like to introduce, after the break, an owner that won the Dairy Bowl last season. We'll get you back.
Hear that fizzle? This week's sponsor of Badgers Beats is Bud Light, the beer of champions. Get drunk as shit after victory and fuck a lot of women. Let's go, baby. Bud Light.
Welcome back to Badgers Speaks. I'm here with extremely explicit owner Noah Douglas. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Thanks for having me on the first ever episode of Badgers Speaks. I'm honored.
So we're going to get started with your exciting news. The G League commissioner is the one that founded it, Noah Douglas. How do you feel about being the commish?
Yeah, it's a great honor for me to come back to what I created and host the G League. I'm very excited. It's going to be great.
Do you have any changes for the G League? Is there anything you want to change?
Yeah, I got a few things on my sleeve, but we're going to wait to announce that at the league meeting.
All right. We had some breaking news over the weekend involving Ryan Cole being back in the league. You were a huge supporter of Ryan being back in the league, but now he's back. How do you feel?
I'm so happy that Ryan's back in the league. The only thing I wish I could have changed is I wish he was on my team.
Wow. So you want Ryan on your team?
You know, it's good because Elijah needs him, but, if I was a free agent, I'd take him.
That's true. So Elijah, actually, he changes his team name from the Cheddar Dogs to the Devil Dogs. How do you feel about that?
I think it's the best name in the league next to mine, probably a little bit after mine, but really good name.
And how do you feel that Alex now has a coaching staff? How do you feel about building your possible coaching staff for Extremely Explicit?
You know, Extremely Explicit probably won't bring in a coaching staff in the coming years, but it's a possibility. I'm just a real huge fan of Mike Turk and those wonderful secretaries down there in Alabama.
Wow.
Especially Kimmy.
You want to say hi to Kimmy?
Hey, Kimmy, how you doing? Come join Explicit.
So we're going to get started with something that's been you've been hoping for the last couple of years, the Herb Cup. How do you feel about that trophy?
To describe it in one word, if I had to, I'd say Explicit.
Wow. And you know, there's a we got to predict here. What is your Herb Cup and who do you have winning?
My Herb Cup, you know, my dream Herb Cup would be me versus Clay. I'd have to say it. We always have great matches, and I think we put on the best show in the league.
Wow. And, you know, you were part of this Dairy Bowl, and you won it. How do you feel? Who do you think is going to be in the Dairy Bowl?
Considering I've won it back-to-back times, I know it pretty well from the back of my hand. And I really don't want to say any names right now, but I think Sean's going to lose.
Wow. Sean's going to lose the league. That's what you think. Well, Noah, thank you for joining us, and that will finish off our first episode of Badger Speaks. Thank you. I love you, people.
Thank you, Badger. Really appreciate it.